Hello YouTube, this is Keith, Kevin, Ken. How you doing? Hope everything's going well for you. It is Thursday, January 26, 2017. I give the day every day, every single day to let you know that we do this every single day. That's right. When I'm feeling well, when I'm feeling a little under the weather, when it's vacation time or whatever, we're talking about what's in our pockets, what makes us feel good. We caress knives here. We don't take them apart. We don't spend a lot of time on the blade steel and all that, okay? And here's the great thing. There are hundreds, literally, no exaggeration, hundreds of YouTube channels that do just that. I watch some of them. This isn't public television for knives. We're just having fun here. So thank you for watching. Hope you enjoy it. Hope you get a chance to see a bunch of knives. When I say we do this every day, we've been doing it for over 340 days. Over 340 days, which means there are over 340 pocket dump deconstructions on a playlist on this channel. So go check them out. They've got headings. You can see which kind of knives and all that stuff. I hope this is the kind of channel that first introduces you to some new knives. Also, when you order a knife, I don't know. Do you do this? I do this all the time, and I've ordered a lot of knives, right? The worst time is you order a knife, it's paid for, and you have to wait for it to get there. Even when I do express shipping, it just seems to take weeks and weeks and weeks and weeks. And so that's when I'm really watching a lot of video about the knife that I have. I'm serious. A lot of them. I hope that you can find some of that here as well to make the wait less painful. So let's talk about this Thursday. I can smell the weekend from here. I can smell it. If I could just survive work, it's been a tough week. That happens. But you know what? It's just work. That's the new Kevin. It's just work. A tough personal life, a tough playtime, a bad watch, a bad cigar. Now that's serious business, folks. Here's the watch for today. It's my Concord Impresario. Man, I remember buying this. Just had gotten a big couple of new clients, back to back, three of them. I went out to celebrate by getting a Concord Impresario, which is just wonderful. Not only is it a wonderful chronograph with a see-through back, but Concord is just a classy watchmaker. Oh, love it. Like I said, you guys know, and maybe you don't, but when I'm having these tough times, I need to feel it on my arm. I need to pat my pockets. I need to know that I'm surrounded by good stuff. I need to know that there's going to be a moment today, tonight, when I turn off YouTube and do all of those things. There's going to be a moment tonight when I cut this and light it, smoke it. Ah, this is a Cohiba Mandora, a dark wrapper. Oh, chocolatey. Yeah, there's gonna be a time. There is. And you know what? There's still Macallan 18 to finish up. Yeah. Some people, when they're having a great time, that's when they celebrate everything, right? Some people say, man, I just closed an account. Man, I just got a raise. Man, I just did that. And they want all the good stuff. It's when I'm struggling a little. You know you're struggling when you're from Cleveland and the Cavaliers are losing to everyone. Nowadays, that's when you know. But you know what? It's just a moment in time, you guys. Oh, man, I'm sounding like some wimpy channel. Okay, I'll stop that. But it is just a moment in time because you know what? Playoffs come. The calves become the calves. Same thing when you're having a bad day. Hey, tomorrow comes. This is the Thai version of my Sean Design pen. Oh, I'm loving it. You know, yesterday I talked about my Sean Design pen and said how I love the fact that it's one bolt, and I talked about the Hinderer. I remember. And that simple pivot on a not-so-simple knife. Same with this. Man, I love it. Ah. Except for the Concord, which I don't know how watches are made and all of that. I love the Concord, and I know the Swiss movements and all of that, and it's an automatic too. Except for that, man, these are real simple things. Knives are kind of simple things too when you think about it. But man, oh man, people do wonderful things with simple things, you know? Like a coin. This coin is the 2012 Chinese lunar coin. I call it flower coin, scallop coin. I like this collection. This is the year of the dragon. Just a wonderful, wonderful coin. I always carry a 1 ounce silver coin for good luck. Have my thin Mont Blanc wallet, one of them. And just the basic black field notes guide. Talk about simple, but so wonderful, man. Especially with these rainy days of January. Thursday, January 26, 2017. This year is only 26 days old, and whew, feels like we've been in it for 5 months already. Hey, I've been searching for some new Spydercos to come out. It's about time they came out, don't you think? I know we got the Para 3, and I know we've got a new addition to the value knives, which I'm excited about. But come on! Time to start releasing those knives. Kevin needs to feel good. This, talk about feeling good. This is the claw coin from Serge Pachenko. I have two of them. I'm always in search of them, and I always come to his website right after they get sold out or something. And I never see them on the secondary market. Drives me insane. But this is the newest one that I just got late last year from Serge. S35VN steel, just a real sharp blade. Of course, it just looks like a nice medallion if you put it around your neck. Of course, I use it as a keychain knife. No one even knows it's a knife until I have to use it for something. But just a wonderful thing. I just like all tie. This is bronze here on this one, along with the pivot. It is a slip joint knife. I'll tell you, I don't know why people get freaked about slip joint knives so much. What's really coming back is just the simple slip joint knives. I mean, I have two. Oh, I have a lot of smaller knives. I have a lot of slip joints. And I just paid a lot of money for two Pena slip joints that I'm in love with. Oh, everything about that is luxurious. It's everything a custom knife should be. It's simple, but man, the craftsmanship. I love. Talk about craftsmanship. This is a knife that people don't talk about that much. It's the Spyderco Air. And it's air because it is as light as air. It's a collaboration with Gail Bradley. You guys know the Gail Bradley and the Gail Bradley 2. You also know that he just released the Advocate, the first flipper from Gail Bradley that I love. He has a fixed blade as well, but this air is something else. The only thing besides the branding on the blade, the only thing that would give you a hint that it might be Gale Bradley is it has CPM M4 steel, because all of his folders do. M4 steel is just a great, retains an edge, strong, but you got to take care of it. It will rust on you. Gets a patina on it. But man, this air is just wonderful. Full tie liners, skeletonized. It has glass fibers. And the interesting thing about this knife is you feel the fibers. You know, a lot of times with Spyderco, when they do glass fibers, like with the Incision, Sprint Runs, and others, you do this and what you feel, they put it under like plexiglass. Here, it's not sticking out or anything. It's smooth, but it has that texture. Remember, these glass fibers are smaller than the human hair, stitched together in this pattern, which is really wonderful. Tie liners. I mean, this is almost just a little bit heavier than that 1 ounce coin. Oh, man. It is a liner lock, of course. It's easy to get to, even with these fat, fumbling hands. Yes, the blade has a little hump to accommodate the spidey hole. But it's not as much because of it's so small, because what they did was they gave you good access this way through this, which is really nice. Really nice. Easy to get to, too. They have a little jimping right here to get to it. It's funny. I usually just use the same hole to close it. But, man, it is a wonderful knife. This is a gentleman's folder, gentlemen. No clip on it. I always put it in a small Chris Reeve sheath when I carry it. They do not have a clip for it. And frankly, well, I guess a clip would... Look, a clip is always handy. The only thing is it would probably weigh almost as much, add a lot of weight to the air, and probably be ugly on the air, too. I can't even imagine a smaller version of my wire clip making this look better. But, oh. Yeah, the Gale Bradley Air, folks. If you're looking for a gentleman's folder that's super light, oh, man, would that be a great wedding present or something? Listen to me like I'm a salesman, but it would be. Oh, I love it. It has a sense of that traditional, even though nothing about that knife is traditional. I just really love it. Here it is, folks. I was talking about the Hinderer. I'm in love with this knife. I've been fighting myself not to get other variations. They already have variations out. This is the Hinderer Half Track. It's one of a pair of brand new designs from Hinderer that just came out middle of last year. This one is a nice one. Real nice one. Love it. It's a small knife. That's what I love. I love it. Flips out there like crazy. S35VN steel. It's 2.75 inches. The blade is the size of a small Nkosi from Chris Reeve. It's thick. It feels like a Hinderer. Feels like it could take on a lot of stuff. I have the one that's full tie with this texturing and this pattern. Clip. Of course, you know, with Hinderers, you could change out the clip and that sort of thing, but I really like it. It looks like it's only, is it? Yeah. Only right-handed tip up on this. It's fine for me because that's what I like. Smooth as butter. Smooth as butter. I love this size. You guys know it. I love that it's the work knife. Of course, I was thinking about, because I needed to feel good, I was thinking about carrying a big custom. And that's why I went with the Air. Because I didn't want, you know, I didn't have a lot of pocket space. I could just drop that in a sheath and it doesn't feel like anything. And that big custom is the knife that got away. But you know what? I said, you know, let's go real small. Light, but nice. Frame lock. Just a wonderful Hinderer in a very small package. And I love the design. I'm glad that Hinderer is starting to come up with even different designs. This is the half track S35VN steel all tie 2.75 inch steel. Everything that makes a Hinderer great, sturdy, well built. And everything that we criticize Hinderer, you can't find it here. The detent's wonderful. It's smooth and just flips from anywhere. I like this carry. Oh, it's light, but I can do some heavy duty. This is a Kevin Harris. Boy, I just said my last name. This is a Kevin carry. Big time Kevin carry. Hey, there's a million of those. Here you go. That's the carry. Thumb it up. Go crazy. Thumbs. Go with the thumb ups. Let me know that you're out there. Don't forget to like. That's the thumbs up sign. That's for me. Don't forget to share. Let people know that we do this every single day. And that there's a big library of videos. A huge library of videos. Huge. With a bunch of knives. Huge with a bunch of knives. And also don't forget to subscribe. We're making our way to 2,000 subscribers. We've got a way to go. We're adding new people coming in every single day. That's great. Once we hit that, I'm giving away two new Spydercos. At least one will be a sprint run. Limited edition. I will be posting a photo on my Instagram at Keith Kevin Ken when it was all purdy, a nice purdy picture of this pocket dump deconstruction. But that's Instagram. This is the Keith Kevin Ken YouTube channel. And this is the knife I was going to carry. Yeah, I have two of them. I got an unexpected bonus, and instead of doing what any middle-aged guy should do, put it away, put it on the van you want to travel and live in. Instead, I went out and bought a number of custom knives. I just went crazy. This is one of two that I have. It's Todd Begg's Bodega 2.0. Yeah. It's 2.0 because I never owned the first one, but I've seen a lot of videos. The first one had, you know, this insert was raised up a bit. Now it's flat. This is the newest of the new. This is as close to custom as you get from Todd Begg without waiting 5 years. So we all call it a custom. Some of the parts, I don't think he makes all the parts, but man, he has a big knife making organization and they do all the other stuff to it. It's a nice knife. 6 ounces. That's why I was thinking about the Air when I was thinking about carrying this. The other one has titanium around here with stainless steel inserts. This stainless steel, it has DLC coating. The steel on this one is N690 steel. Just a wonderful 3.75 inches. Man, it flies out there. Listen. Whoops, that was me. Flies. The insert, these new limited editions that he has art on them. In this case, it's the Norse. Just a wonderful, look at the art. Just wonderful. They're limited. This is number 14. The number 14 is not the knives. It's the print. So this is number 14 of the print. Oh. Crush ice, you know, this pivot, custom pivot. Rides on IKBS ceramic. Ah! If you look, I love the crushed ice right here on the pivot. You can also see crushed ice on the titanium clip with a black ceramic ball. It's just wonderful. Has crushed ice too. Let's see how close we can get this sucker. Has crushed ice too. Can you see here? This right here is the interesting thing about the Bodega. You see these three screws and this part? It hooks up with the frame lock. You take those screws out. You take this whole bottom part. You move the clip. Whole bottom part and the lock. Send that in. They can send you a new one to just replace if the lock has a problem. But look at the crushed ice effect all through this. That's what I mean about custom. He just does all this. Ah, the backspacer, titanium backspacer. You know, I knew it was IKBS. I bought this directly from him on his website, Todd Begg. But I was like, wait, he has DLC coding. I don't see the logo. Well, there's the logo, the IKBS logo. Oh man, this is a dream. I just love it. I love this and the other one that I have. But you know what? While I needed something great in my pocket that felt good and all, and I was turning to my customs and I really wanted to carry this, but really I want to feel classy and strong. This is classy and strong, by the way. Oh, you can use it. This is classy and strong. But I think I'll keep this one at home. I've been flipping it all morning. When I get home, I'm going to flip it all night. When I'm smoking my cigar, I'll be flipping that and the sister of that with a dragon lady on it, the full tie version. Ah, what a wonderful knife. I feel fortunate. I have to flip a knife like that to feel fortunate, where I go, okay, let's go make the money. This is part of what we're working for. And that's it, you guys. That's all of it. Thank you very much for watching. I really appreciate you guys giving me so much of your time. I know what time's worth. I see mine going away faster and faster. So the fact that you can spend some of it with me, that means a lot to me. You have a perfect day. Keep those pockets full. Goodbye.